Round them up. It's going to be April 11th. It's only going to be the third episode this month, so this is episode 3. First-time viewers, thanks for tuning in. There's a car or truck you're looking for. Drop in the comments below, and we'll round them up for you. Today's search is going to be on me. We're going to go over some wreckers and tow trucks. It's kind of like what I used to do for 20-plus years of my life. So kind of know a little bit about these kind of trucks. So to get started here, we're going to see Craigslist, some Facebook Marketplace. It always goes lowest to highest. Just drop in your URL up the top right here, and it'll bring you to any of these ads. They're all currently for sale. This first one's going to be in Boston. It's going to be a 78 Chevy 3500 with a C30 Holmes Wrecker tow truck bed on it. So yeah, $1,700. So mind you, we are staying $5,000 and under. A lot of these trucks are going to be really wore out worked trucks. So they're going to need work, they're going to need repairs. And some of them are going to be old school. So if you don't know how to use a sling, I wouldn't even recommend getting one. This is old school stuff. This is like for the tow truck guys in my era. We started out, this is how we hauled everybody's shit. So I dig the B&M shifter handle. I dig that it's old school. It's got a twin line winch on it. And we can read them out. So let's read them out. It's a 78 GMC 3500 4-speed with the granny gear. It's got a 4-bolt main 350 in it. Completely rebuilt. Myself, 350's 2 weeks, so we're just going to stop there. I wouldn't have a wrecker with a little 350 Chevy in it. This thing has a hard time pulling itself down the road, as heavy as it is. So if you're not familiar with these trucks, never had a wrecker, and you're thinking about getting an old school wrecker, make sure it's a big black Chevy if it's one of these trucks. So $1,700, and it was not updated. It was 26 days ago. We're just going to scroll right to the next one. This one's only one photo. And I don't usually run one photos because these could be scam ads. So you got to make sure this is a real legitimate ad. It says posted 7 days ago. It's a 61 Ford 4x4. And it's going to be in, I'm not sure where this is at. So we'll have to scroll out a little bit here on the map and see. It's going to be in Phoenix, Arizona. And by the looks of the picture, I should have guessed that. So yeah, only one pick. I dig this style of Ford truck though. So it's an old one. It's $3,500. It's got the 292 4-speed, 8-bolt wheels, original paint, complete, was running 4 years ago, but was using a fair amount of oil. I will post more pics in a few days, so I'd wait a few days before I hit this dude up, just to make sure he puts more photos on here and you see what you're looking at. Or you just hit him up, so drop the URL, check it out. Phoenix, Arizona, looking for an old 61 Ford. Boom, just found you one. So on to the last Craigslist ad, and this thing's just wicked. This thing reminds me of that movie where the truck chases them people down the road. I can't even remember the name of the movie, it was so old, but this is a cool truck. It's an antique tow truck. As a matter of fact, what it says, a 61 International. So you gotta dig that. Only one photo, and I don't dig that. So it's in Western Mass. 15 days ago, looking for a big school yard art. This thing would be cool just to put out front to promote your business. I mean, $3,500, you'll pay more than that for a real cool sign. So you can't beat that. On to another one. And this is going to start off at some Facebook Marketplace. And check this thing out. This is going to be in South Dakota. And this is a Chevy truck, four-wheel drive frame and engine with a Ranchero sitting on it. And yeah, they left the boom in it. So you want something different? Bam. This is definitely different. I wouldn't recommend buying it. It's got 327 in it. It's just, it was $1,200. Why not include it? So there it is. On to another one. And check this yard art out. Like I was just saying a minute ago, you can't even buy a road sign. You can't even buy a big sign to put out in front of your tow business for $1,700. So yeah, you just buy this, throw your Sanford and Son on the side of it with the phone number of your business and whatnot. Boom. Perfect advertisement. Or check it out if you want to restore this thing. This is a cool Chevy. It's a 64. And it's pretty sweet. I mean, for what it is, $1,700. It's worth checking out. Especially if you like the old school working your ass off to haul a car. So on to another one. This one again is going to be a 67 Chevy for $2,300. So, I mean, okay, and look at the advertisement on this thing. He's doing exactly what I just been saying. advertise your business with this thing. Just set it out front. So would I tow stuff with this? Nah, but restore it up cool enough, you can take it to the car show. So I'm digging that. I mean, that was in New York. $2,300. On to another one. Now we're getting into some real trucks you could probably actually put back to use. $2,500. It's an 87 Ford F-350 tow truck with a 7.3 with the 5-speed. It's got the 480 Holmes with twin line on it. It's got hydraulic wheel lift. It runs and drives. It's been sitting for a few years and needs some TLC. Called John. It's got his phone number on it. It says $2,500 best offer. So check it out. This is probably worth checking out. If you're in the PA area and you're looking for a wrecker, boom. Just found you one worth checking out right here. I'm digging it. It had the wheel lift. It also had the sling on it. It's got twin line Holmes on it. Cool truck. On to another one. This one's going to be $2,700. It's going to be in Illinois. It's a 79 GMC. And it's got a 454 in it. And it's $2,700, a best offer. So you got to dig that. It's got a plow on it. It's got a wheel lift on it. It's got a sling on it. It's got dollies on it. It's four-wheel drive. This should have been a choice of the day, probably, because this is way cooler than the Dodge that I love. This thing's got everything. So even if you got to put some money back into this truck and put $5,000-$6,000 in it, you're going to have one hell of a truck when this thing's done. So I'm digging this one. Check it out. Illinois. On to another one. This is going to be a 79 Ford F-350 Custom. He's wanting $2,750 for this. Says it runs and drives and all the towing equipment works. So how can you beat that? It's going to be in... I'm not even sure where this is at. I got to put my glasses on to see. Mississippi. I do believe. Moss Point. So let's check out the pictures. Sorry about that, guys, gals. I ain't got the light off here. I don't have my glasses on, so... can't see very good without my glasses. There we go. Hopefully that doesn't reflect on the screen, but I got a little bit of light now. So yeah, we can see it's Mississippi. Check it out, $2,750. This ain't a bad looking old Ford. Again, good advertisement. But this is one you could probably work, especially if you know how to use a sling truck. So on to another one. This has got your wheel lift on it. It's even got a ball hooked on the end of the wheel lift. You gotta love when you do that, dude. You just back up close to a trailer, you can pivot this thing, makes it go 3 or 4 inches to the right or left. And with the in and out, you can hook up trailers. Piece of cake with this truck. I dig the stacks. It sucks it's got twin line winches, but I see the booms are gone. So that kind of sucks that the booms are missing. But let's read him out. Selling a 91 F450 Super Duty with a 7.3 diesel, runs and drives. And stops as it should. It's got a 5-speed manual with a good clutch. It's got the 2 winches on it. Has a wheel lift on it. But we'll need some work with the hydraulic line attention. So more than likely it's going to be one of the hydraulic lines that goes inside this wheel lift. And they're a real pain in the ass to put in, but it's doable. So it's not a reason to stare away from it. You'll know if it works. As long as it's got fluid in it, you should still operate. And you'll see where it's leaking from. So let's scroll through some pictures here. Not a bad looking truck on the inside. Usually these seats on these wreckers are wore out a lot worse than that. I like that it's orange and black. Put a couple Harley stickers on it. This thing would be looking pretty sweet. So yeah, I dig it. It's in Wisconsin. 91 for $2,750. Still got the light bar and it's got stacks. So you got to dig that. On to another one. This one's going to be $3,300 and it's going to be Cleveland, Ohio. It's going to be a 97 Ford F450. It's got the 7.3 power stroke in it. It's got a Century 411 bed with wheel lift and boom. Truck needs a fuel pump. So that would kind of scare me that it needs a fuel pump. Means you're going to go out there and you're not going to hear it run. But you should be able to hit it with ether and at least get it to start up. But... 2 photos kind of sucks too. So if it's something you're interested in, Cleveland area, just get on here, put in facebook.com/marketplace/item number/this number, and like all these ads, you put in that number, it'll bring you right to the ad. On to another one. This one's going to be $3,500. It's going to be in Florida. So that's pretty cheap for anything in Florida. But check it out. It's an 85 F-350. It's got a tow truck with working air. So it's got AC. You got to dig that. It's got new plugs, wires, carburetor. We'll trade. What do you got? So it sounds like it's completely operable. So you got to dig that too. For $3,500, you're towing them. So on to another one. This is a pretty cool truck right here too. I mean, it's got the faded paint, but man, paint's not that expensive. So check it out. $3,500 in Tennessee. It's an 85 Chevy Wrecker. It's got the C30, new tires, new seat cover, new dash pad, rebuilt injector pump, new windows, felt rubbers, new master cylinder, new wiper motor, new front brakes, new mud flaps, new fuel tank. PTO and winches work good, 6.2 diesel, no leaks. So man, I like the sounds of all that. And the price, $3,500. So yeah, you're wanting a wrecker. Boom, sling action. Again, you have to have some J-hooks and know what you're doing, but they will get it done. Really decent looking truck right here. So Tennessee, check it out. If you're looking for a cool wrecker, boom, just found it for you. You got to recoup some of your money just getting rid of these three lights and putting a nice light bar on it. So again, check them out. On to another one. I like this truck a lot. So this one's in Kentucky, posted 4 hours ago. So this is as fresh as they get sometimes here. So this is an 87. It's got a 454 with a 4-speed. So I like that it's gas too. And it's the big block, like I told y'all, you need. If you're going to have one of these Chevy Wreckers, it's going to need them big cubic inches. So it says it needs a hydraulic line. It only costs $30. But again, it's probably going to be the hydraulic line that's inside of that wheel lift. It's going to be a pain in the ass to put it in, but it's doable. It just takes some work. So on to some pictures of this one. And there you go. It's got a Sling Twin Lines. This is an awesome truck for the money. So if you're looking for a wrecker, boom, hit this guy up. This is a deal, Kentucky. Check it out. Even got a nice light bar on this truck. On to another one. So it's going to be an 83. It's going to be $4,000. He's listing it for a friend. It's hydraulic boom with dual winches, and it all works. So you got to dig that. It's in Ohio. But there's going to be the fallback right there. It's got a small block Chevy in it. So that's killing this truck. To have it run right, it would need a diesel or a big block Chevy put in it. That would be the only thing I'd have against this truck. Otherwise, it looks pretty decent. Don't look like a bad truck at all, other than the engine size. On to another one. This is going to be a 97 Ford F-250. Wants $4,000 for this one. This has the 5.8, which is a really good engine that Ford made right there. Everything works in and out. It can be driven. $4,000 or best offer. May consider trades, just ask. So it does have the extended cab. That does show a little bit of rust. It does look like a Sling hanging from it, but it does have the wheel lift, so you got to dig that. I'm liking this one too. For $4,000, this is worth checking out. This could be a really good record right here. Again, another one in Ohio. So on to another one. This is going to be at a dealership. And it's going to be an 85 F-350 tow truck record with twin line winches, wheel lift. It's 4x4. It's 4-speed. Special price is cash price. We accept all bank loans too. So that's what it says about it. And it's four-wheel drive. So I dig that. I dig that it's got the twin line winch on it. It's a cool truck right here. Definitely get a lot done with this. Check out how high they got that motorcycle. That gold wing's swinging. Got that thing picked way up. So yeah, I drove a lot of these Fords throughout the years of doing what I've done. And these trucks, I've been 20, like I said, 20 years plus years I was a tow truck operator. So, telling you, these Fords are one badass truck. I'm not a Ford guy, but when it comes to their workhorse trucks, their 460 gas engines, if you can get one with a gas engine in it, I highly recommend it. There's nothing like a 460 in one of these Fords. So on to another one. This is going to be an 88 Ford for $4,400. It's in really good condition, ready for the road. It says, or best offer. So you kind of got to dig that. This truck looks really clean, man. It's got nice paint on it. Nice wheel simulators. It's got the boom. It's got the wheel lift. Check it out. $4,400. New York area. So be safe. Be careful. If you're going to look at anything in New York, obviously, take the precautions to be safe. On to another one. This one's going to be in Ohio again. This is going to be a 78 Ford. And this is going to be a rollback. So I didn't include too many rollbacks tonight, but this was a nice rollback. For $4,500, and it's got wheel lift on the end of it. I mean, even the seat, the interior, this is just a sweet looking rig right here. Check it out. Posted about a day ago. So if you're wanting to get your own flatbed, man, you gotta check this out. In Ohio, $4,500 a day ago. Runs and drives and stops, four speed, works. No use for it. Looking for trades, a nice dually truck, or $4,500. We'll trade for a nice Harley too, he says, but for $4,500, damn, just go buy this thing. You gotta dig it. On to another one. This one's gonna be a 96 Chevy in Virginia. What's $4,500 for this truck? It's a 3500 wrecker with a 454 5-speed. So you got to dig this. Still got the big block in it. It's got the dual line winches. It's got the sling. And it's got the wheel lift. So you got to dig all that. Look like some decent tires on the back still. Obviously, if it's been sitting, you'd have to see if they're dry rotted or not. But regardless, $4,500 with this style bed on it. And it runs and dries. Boom. You have to check this out. Not a bad looking record right here. I'm digging it. Again, for only $4,500. On to another one. It's going to be a 77 Chevy in Indiana. And again, it's kind of like a flatbed. This is a wedge bed with the sleeper. So you got to dig that. I always dig these square body Chevys. So digging that it's got a sleeper, but he doesn't show you inside of it. Looks like this could be a lot of wood on here. Does have some nice aluminum ramps, has a spare for the truck. So yeah, race car hauler, boom. Circle car, track hauler, boom. Gotta dig it. For only $4,500, yeah man, check it out. 62.2 diesel, and it's best offer. Or trade for an old car. Indiana, on to another one. So it's gonna be in PA, this can be a 93 Ford F450. He wants $4,900 for this one. It's a 93 Super Duty wrecker with a 7.3, 12,000 miles on the rebuild. It's got a 5-speed in it with a new clutch. Almost 4 new rear tires. Just did an 8-hour trip with it with zero problems. $4,900 firm. So yeah, this is a pretty good looking record too right here. And he's saying hop in it and roll, boys, gals. Guys, looking for a record that's turnkey and ready to work tomorrow? Boom. This 93 right here sounds like it's ready to go. And I gotta admit, I've had a couple of this gen trucks. They are beasts. The automatic transmissions, on the other hand, you got a problem with the transmission in one of those, boy, you're gonna pay up. So you're always better off staying with a 5-speed manual in any kind of wrecker, in my opinion. On to another one. This is going to be an 02 for $5,000. It's an F450. It's got the 7.3, and here you go. It's a manual transmission. That's what you want to hear. Truck has 105,000 on it. Runs and drives great. Asking 5,000 or best offer in Michigan. This is an awesome truck. This is obviously better than the pick of the day. If you honestly want a work truck, this would be the one you'd go get. I don't see how you couldn't go wrong. This is going to need a lot of work. Suspension parts are going to be wore out. Sure they are. But that's all going to be a part of it. You're going to realize if you got one of these kind of trucks, you got to stay up on the maintenance anyway. So from the day you get it, you redo it, you know what it's got new. You know what it's gonna need. Nice light bar on this. Excuse my pop-ups. And let's go to that last truck of the day. Obviously, this was on our truck episode back when I did some 78 Dodges like this, 77, 78 Dodge trucks. But I just love this truck. It's $4,500. It was in West Virginia. It's a 440 4-speed. It don't have a wheel lift on it. It's an old school sling truck. But I just dig that it's 440. I dig that it's a 4-speed. I dig that it's got dual stacks. And I dig that it's the cab that I've always loved. The body style Dodge truck I've always loved. So that's why this was the pick of the day. It's because this is my channel. And this was my search. And I can do what I want to do. Hey everybody, peace, love, y'all be safe, and like always, peace out.